Anesthesia is arguably medicine's greatest gift of all. To surgeons that began their medical studies after the 1850s, it is next to impossible to imagine the practice of surgery before anesthesia. Just over 160 years ago, optional surgery was performed very infrequently, prior to the discovery of anesthesia. Few operations were even possible, and surgeons were judged by their speed rather than their accuracy. Some surgeries, such as amputations, had to be performed in record time. Some were recorded to have legs amputated in less than a minute's time. Surgery was always a last and usually a desperate resort to save a life. This view and fear of surgery was very damaging to the public health system due to the fear of surgeries. Many of the surgeries done in the early 1800s had people so frightened that just from the first touch of the knife, many had jumped off the operating table, and others had been reported to break free from their restraints and run from the room at great speeds. Some even committed suicide before the surgery, finding death to be a much more pleasant alternative than surgery. Over the centuries, numerous techniques have been used to dull the sensation of surgery. Soporifics, or sleep-inducing agents, psychosomatic medications, or emphasis of unity between the mind and body, alcohol, opium, morphine, narcotics, and other sedatives were used to try to dull the pain for surgery. Surgeons were said to walk in with two bottles of whiskey, one for the patient and one for himself, so he could withstand the patient's shrieks. But if alcohol or opium had to be used, the large doses of alcohol that were required were likely to cause nausea and death, rather than the intended result of sleep, and opium had many side effects, and wasn't powerful enough to completely dull the pain. Most surgeons just had their patients held down by strong men or strapped down to the operating table. Many patients fainted from the shock, pain, and agony. Many even died. Healers even attempted to induce a psychological state of anesthesia by hypnosis. Another crude method was knocking the patient unconscious with a blow to the jaw. Distraction could be used by rubbing the patient with counter-irritants such as stinging nettles. Although anesthetics were first administered in 1842 by Crawford Long, the impact on general medicine practice began in the year 1846, when William Morton, a Boston dentist, had demonstrated the use of ether, a volatile organic solvent, during surgery, ending the indescribable pain and overwhelming dread that had always up to this point been associated with the surgeon's knife. Morton had administered the anesthetic to Gilbert Abbott, using a specially designed glass inhaler containing an ether-soaked sponge. Abbott was a printer who had come to the Massachusetts General Hospital to receive treatment for a vascular tumor on his jaw. After a few minutes of being administered the ether, he was rendered unconscious, and John Warren surgically removed the tumor. Upon awakening, Abbott informed the medical students and the physicians in the area that he had experienced no pain whatsoever. The news from Boston swept around the world, and within weeks, anesthesia was hailed to be the greatest gift ever made to suffering humanity. It was one of the moments that had changed medicine forever. Furthermore, what was only known before as the Massachusetts General Hospital was later to be known everywhere as the Ether Dome. Anesthesiology has expanded far beyond the small operating room in the Massachusetts General Hospital. The medical breakthrough known as anesthesia is partially responsible for the great improvements in patient safety and comfort during and after surgery. With anesthesia, we were able to conquer pain, and the enormous progress we made in surgery was made possible. Many other agents had followed the discovery of ether as an anesthetic, including chloroform in 1847 and local anesthesia in 1877. Not only were people able to benefit from the discovery, but animals were too. By the year 1867, horses were beginning to receive the advantage also. It had been successfully applied locally by means of ether and wriggling spray. This successful discovery proved to be very helpful in that it helped save many horses' lives by operations which otherwise would prove to be impossible or fruitless without the use of anesthesia. "Your anesthesiologist is probably the doctor you know least," says Warren Zappel, chief of anesthesia and critical care at the Massachusetts General Hospital. "But while you're in the operating room, he or she is responsible for keeping you safe during surgery." Since the discovery of anesthesia, surgeons have been able to become more accurate, take more time, and undertake more complex procedures. The discovery had marked the moment when Boston, and indeed the United States, had first emerged as a world-class center of medical innovation. Even in this great day and age, where we find ourselves with such great medical possibilities, there are still countries who can't afford the use of anesthesia, such as Haiti. With the recent earthquake, the country doesn't have any access to medications and supplies, so thousands of emergency amputations and surgeries had to be completed without the use of anesthesia. What the great moment in the Massachusetts General Hospital really marked was something less tangible, but far more significant. It was the huge cultural shift in the idea of pain. With the discovery of anesthesia, operating with it would transform medicine, considerably expanding the extent of what doctors were able to accomplish. What was necessary to change during this time was not the technology, which had been long since created, but it was medicine's readiness to use it. Nowadays, anesthesia is very safe, with a mortality rate of less than 1 in 250,000. Currently, we do not use ether as an anesthetic anymore because it is not powerful enough and it was hard to administer to patients. In this day and age, we use local anesthesia, medication given to stop pain for short amounts of time and the patient remains conscious, regional anesthesia, usually used for numbing an area of nerves that provides feeling to that part of the body, and general anesthesia, which causes the patient to become unconscious during the surgery. Today's general anesthesia is made up of thiopentone sodium, which acts within 30 seconds of being injected. Some local anesthetics include benzocaine, lidocaine, and novocaine, which are commonly used in dental procedures and for medical examinations. Nevertheless, with today's sophisticated monitoring systems and a greater understanding of bodily functions, the anesthetic profession will continue to strive for improvement.